Thank you. Atmanam Nirmini Yakshana Dasya Niralokam.
Niralokam.
Without any light.
Without any light.
Atmanam.
Atmanam.
His own transcendental body.
His own transcendental body.
Cha.
Cha.
Also other bodily forms.
Also other bodily forms.
Didrikshata.
Didrikshata.
Desire to look upon.
Desire to look upon.
Nibbine.
Nibbine.
Due to being sprouted. Thus, when everything existed in darkness, the Lord desired to see Himself and all that was created. Then the eyes, the illuminating God, Sun, the power of vision and the object of sight, all became manifested. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. The universe is by nature dense darkness, and therefore the total creation is called tamas or darkness. The night is the real feature of the universe, for then one cannot see anything, including oneself. The Lord, out of His causeless mercy, first desired to see Himself and all the creation as well. And thus the Son became manifested. The power of vision for all living entities became possible, and the objects of vision were also manifested. This means that the whole phenomenal world became visible after the creation of the sun. Om Jnana Vimarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chatsur Nirvitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manoviskam Sapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Pandeham Shri Kurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Savaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Visha He Krishna Karna Sindhu Hina Bandhu Jagat
ॐ नमो नमः
जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 Sukadeva Goswami is telling us how the Virata Purush is developing the beginning of creation. And today we're hearing about the power of seeing and the eyes and how it depends on the sun. In the darkness of night, we cannot see anything. So, Prabhupada explains to us that the nature of this universe is darkness. Without the sun, there's no light in the universe. If you live in the lower regions of the universe, that is below Bhumandala, then all the different subterranean planets, subterranean heavenly planets, and the hellish planets are there. Yamaraj's planet is also there. Yamaraj, the god of death who punishes the sinful people. They all live in the lower regions of the universe. But the sun is in the upper region of the universe. And they don't get any light of the sun. Because the light of the sun is covered by Bhumandala. Bhumandala covers the whole area and there's no rays of the light to go into the lower regions. We only get half a day of sunlight, right? Every month the sun rises and sun sets in the course of the day, about 12 hours. And the rest of the time the sun is hidden from us, we're in darkness. So, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is taken Krishna Suryasam Maya Haya Antikar. Yahan Krishna Tahannahi Maya Antikar. The saying Krishna is like the sun, and wherever there is sunlight, there will be no darkness. Maya is like darkness. The absence of Krishna is like darkness. But wherever there is the light of the sun, there's no darkness. And the same way, wherever there is Krishna, there is no Maya. Just like the sun, now we're in the light of the sun, there's no darkness. But we know in course of time, and that by the time it comes to this time in the evening, like 8:30 in the evening, it will be dark. Because the sun is covered, is hidden from our vision. In the same way, when we're in Krishna consciousness, there's no mind. But as soon as we leave Krishna consciousness, immediately we're in Maya. You don't have to wait for the Maya to come. Just like we don't wait for the darkness to come. As soon as you put out the light, the darkness is there. So this planet and the whole universe is in darkness. But when the sun comes, in the presence of the sun, then the darkness is removed. In the same way, when we are in Krishna consciousness, there is no Maya. And as soon as we forget Krishna, immediately we're in Maya. So we want to always be attentive, to be always alert, to stay in Krishna consciousness. How can we become alert to always be in Krishna consciousness? Well, one thing you can do is constantly chant the holy name. If we keep the holy name on our tongue, then that will protect us from mind. We want to always be engaged in Krishna's service. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna was describing how to overcome the modes of nature. Right. Who knows which chapter in the Bhagavad Gita Krishna describes the three modes of material nature? Okay, you take off the one and yes. When I was engaged in my devotional service without falling down, then he transcends the modes of nature and comes to the level of Brahman. So we transcend the modes of nature, we come to the level of Brahman. On the level of Brahman, we experience bliss. In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes Brahma Buddha Prasannatma. Brahma Buddha Prasannatma. Prasannatma. There was a devotee, Prabhupada disciple. Prabhupada gave him the name Prasannatma. Means a joyful soul. So who is Prasannatma? Who is a joyful soul? One who knows that he is Brahman, that he is not the body. Right? Brahma Buddha, one who understands I'm not the body, I'm Brahman. And the nature of Brahman is to be joyful. to think that the body will be miserable. How can you be happy living in a material body? Well, Prabhupada said, and there's only two people who are happy. One is the Krishna conscious person, and the other is the fool. The fool thinks, I'm happy in my material body. Although the material body is meant for suffering, we're thinking we're happy. It's very, very easy to give pain to the material body. Any little thing goes wrong with your body and you suffer so much. Maybe somebody stands in your pool. Somebody pulls your ear. There's so many different ways the body gives us pain. Can you think, how do you get pleasure from the body? Can you imagine giving pleasure to your toe? You can get pain very easily, but to get pleasure from the toe, very difficult. This body is just meant for suffering. But foolish people are thinking, I am happy, I'm enjoying my body. And so Krishna consciousness is to bring us to the platform of Brahmana. To understand we're not the body, that we're spiritual entities, part and parcel of the Lord. And it's not wrong to want to be happy. It's not wrong to want to enjoy. But we have to know where to find the happiness, where to get the enjoyment. You don't get the happiness just from the material body. We don't get the happiness here in this material world. But we can get real happiness from the soul and bringing our soul back to Godhead. So there is happiness, there is enjoyment, and we can have that happiness and enjoyment. But we have to get it in Krishna consciousness. Not in this Maya, trying to enjoy the material body in the material world. The material world is described in the Bhagavad Gita that it is dukkhalayam ashasva. A temporary place of misery. In the material world, the material body, all meant for misery, all to give us suffering. But the soul, the spiritual energy is meant to give us bliss. By nature, we are all Satchit Ananda, we are all full of eternity, knowledge, and bliss. But we're suffering because we're identifying with the body. So when we become Brahma Buddha, when we know that we're not the body, when we understand our spiritual position, then we will experience real pleasure. But to come to that Brahma Buddha platform, we have to know the process, how to get there. If we're caught in the modes of nature, it's very difficult to get free. If you're way down in the bottom of the mode of ignorance, it's very difficult to come up to the Brahma Buddha platform. It's a big jump up. Maybe we come more in the mode of passion, rajagun, but still it's a big way up to get out of the modes of nature. How to get up to that, out of the modes of nature, we simply have to take shelter of devotional service. Devihi esha gunamaye mama maya duratyaya. The maya is very difficult to get free from. But maya prapadyante mayami tamtaranti te. It's very easy if you take shelter of Lord Krishna. And we take shelter of Lord Krishna by engaging in his devotional service. By chanting his holy names, by worshipping his deity, by reading his scriptures. In this way we can engage our senses in the service of Krishna. We awaken our original consciousness. The darkness is removed where there is the light of Krishna. So the Srimad Bhagavatam was spoken in the absent, because Lord Krishna left the planet. He left the world. So there had to be some religious principles present. So the Srimad Bhagavatam appeared, and it's described that this Srimad Bhagavatam is as brilliant as the sun. People who have lost their vision, in other words, the darkness, due to the darkness of the age of Kali, they've lost their vision. They will get light from this Puran. And we offer our prayers every day. We're saying, Om Agyana Tivaramnasya. I was born in the darkness, ignorance. But my spiritual master opened my eyes with the torchlight of knowledge. So Srimad Bhagavatam is also transcendental knowledge, opening our eyes to the reality of life. We don't like to open our eyes, we don't like to look and see. We're enjoying the body. We're thinking we're enjoying the body. I have my nice home. I have my family members. Maybe you have a dog or a cat. Or a little bird. Or some goldfish. And we're thinking, this is my home. But we have to give all these things up one day. You have to leave everything. You have to go take another birth. So we heard, yes, we were speaking yesterday about the next birth. We have to get ready for the next birth. Where do we want to go next? Okay. Now we have this body, human body, fortunate human body. There's a nice song we sing. Bhaja Harimana Srinandanandana Abhaya Charanaravindure Durlabha Manava Janama Satsange Taraho Yebavo Sindure. This is a very nice song which devotees often sing. We have to teach it to you sometime. Anyway, the meaning is that we should use our mind to worship Krishna, the son of Nanda Maharaj. And he said, the song goes on to say that by worshipping the lotus feet of Lord Krishna, we will become fearless. In the material world, everyone's full of fear. No, we're afraid. We're afraid of the government. We're afraid of the officials. We're afraid of the policemen. We're afraid of the doctors. We're afraid of all the nasty people who come and can give us a lot of trouble. Yeah, we live in fear. But we have achieved this rare human body. Durlabha Manava Janama Sat. It's very rare to get the human birth. There's so many species of life. Look in Malaysia, there's so many trees everywhere. Many trees and many insects also. Many mosquitoes. Many viruses. There's so many things. See, we're so fortunate we have got the human body. But not only have we got the human body, we've got association with devotees. Durlabha Manava Janamasas Taraho Yebavo Sindure. In the association of devotees, we can cross over the ocean of material existence. Without the association, it's very difficult to cross the ocean. You wouldn't want to have your own little boat and go and try to cross the ocean on your own. But if we get a nice ship means that this Krishna conscious movement is a nice ship to help us cross the ocean.
这个坚固的船只是什么呢？就是这不是能决定的，可以帮助我们跨越什么事实啊。
And we have Srila Prabhupada as the captain of the ship.
Srila Prabhupada 就是我们这个船上的船长。
And we have a nice breeze to help us cross the ocean, the Srimad Bhagavatam.
我们也有顺风帮助我们跨越，那这个风就是圣贤的法船。
So in this way, we can all get free from all the miseries of material life.
那最后呢，我们就可以跨越这个物质生活的痛苦。
We just have to take advantage of this association.
我们所需要做的呢，就是好好的利用这个联谊机会。
Okay, any questions?
那个有人说，不在 Krishna 世界中，就在 Maya 中，在 Krishna 世界中就没 Maya。有没有这种情况？有的人既在 Maya 中，又在 Krishna 世界中。比如说，他抽烟的时候，他想着 Krishna。他喝酒的时候，他也想着亏损。这种情况是在玛雅中还是在亏损之中？
Oh, it's not pure Krishna consciousness. It's mixed.There are people who make a show of being Krishna conscious, but at the same time they're very attached to material life. Then you get people, they're big scholars, they know all the slokas, they know everything about Krishna.And whenever they take their cigarettes, they put a tosi there. Put the tosi in their tea when they're drinking the tea. So that's not pure Krishna consciousness.To Krishna, but they're not free of mind. And so we want to see pure Krishna consciousness, not some just talking, making a show. And at the same time, enjoying the material world.Having their cigarettes, having their alcohol. You know, sometimes when we give class online, people are listening to the class at the same time they're smoking a cigarette or something. So they. You know, they have some interest in Krishna, but they're still very strongly attached to the material world. They have to give up these sinful activities. And then only they can make progress. Without following the four regulator principles,They're not making any real progress. But they have some show of devotion. They have some attraction to Krishna. So they need to get strong association.Somebody has to cut that attachment which they have for their sense gratification. We know, we get people like that, they come along and they want to get initiation and they still have so many bad habits. We have to educate people. We have to understand there's devotional service in the modes. But we are interested in pure devotion. Rupa Goswami teaches us about pure devotion. But if you read Srimad Bhagavatam, third canto, Lord Kapila talks about how there's devotion in passion and ignorance and goodness. Okay. So people are doing like that. They're worshipping the deity, they come off the altar and smoke a cigarette. So that's in devotion of service and ignorance. Devotional service and passion is done. You want to get name and honor for yourself. I'm a great devotee. So that's the mode of passion. And the mode of goodness is you want to destroy
sin.
You do devotional service just simply to get rid of our past karma. But pure devotion is done simply for the pleasure of Lord Krishna. We simply want to please
Krishna.
Anya vilasita sunyam jnana karma janavritam anukoyena Krishna nushilanam bhaktir uttamam. Rupa Goswami has given us this definition of pure devotion. That there should be no desire for furtive activities or philosophical speculation. Means you're not interested in liberation. One should simply want to serve Krishna favorably. You know, Kamsa was also thinking of Krishna, but he was thinking to kill Krishna. So that is not favorable to devotional service. Or any other question? Mukunda, I signed all the forms if you want to give them out now.
Well, the difference is
that in Raghunuga Bhakti, one is spontaneously attracted to Krishna without thinking about the rules and regulations. You know, in the beginning, to wake up in the morning, maybe we have to have a clock, and the alarm clock will wake us up. But after some time, you become habituated, and you wake up without the clock. So spontaneous Raghunuga Bhakti is that like that, that you know, you just naturally want to serve. Without even thinking about all the rules and regulations. But one should not be neglected. We should not try to imitate somebody on the right. But if somebody is actually on the Raghunuga platform, they will naturally follow the rules and regulations. Without even thinking about the rules. It depends how you're associating with them. You have to think your husband is also a part and parcel of Krishna. You have to see the spirit soul in him also. You have to want to try to dovetail that mood, Krishna consciousness, in your home, in your family life. You have an altar at home, you have deity at home, you're offering your food at home. So you're doing a lot of things for the service of Krishna. At the same time, you cannot be neglectful. You have a family, you have a husband, you have to show care for them, you have to show your concern and interest in them. Because of your husband, he's helping you in Krishna consciousness. He probably pays for you to come on this trip. I don't know who gives the money. So you have to appreciate that he's doing service for Krishna. And you have to encourage him.
你需要鼓励他。
Maybe in the future you can bring him also.
也许下一次将来你把他一起带走。
哎呦！
Yes, so being a married woman, you should not be neglectful, don't be artificial, you should take care and please your husband. Prabhu here can give you more advice.
Yes, please join. You will definitely get a lot of benefit just by coming, hearing all the questions, how the answer comes about, and very practical, very, very practical. You will love it. Just a matter of opening up yourself to how to view your family members and all that, it's very easy actually. It's a matter of being patient about it. It would be nice if they don't give you any hassle, any problem, any anger. You are satisfied. That would be the first thing that we like you to go through. So make sure that all your loved ones accept who you are. And that is the process.
就是不要对家人生气、愤怒，就情绪化，要让家里人呢，心意平和，对我们感到满足。这样的话，会接家人会接受我们。
So this one is a certificate that's been organized by the ISKCON Melaka here for those who attended the Rajyatra and also performed in the Rajyatra. So you get a certificate to have a remembrance of the Rajyatra here on the 1st of January. And all this is officially and properly signed by your Guru Maharaj. And so it's your Guru's name is right here, signed just now. And some of you have a name, because I got the name of those performers, but the others and the rest also get a certificate. So sorry, Pajendra Prabhu.
Hey!
所以其他没有那个唱说的可以上来来一张给姑姑，你的姑姑给他的签名两个来签名来，没有的其他人没有拿到的上来也一张，全部都有，上来快点来拿姑姑给。Okay, 如果帮你写名啊，那我们就没问题。如果帮你写，就得分了。哎呦！啊，如果写给你啊。哎呦！
秘密。